Hello everybody, welcome back. I have something very exciting to show you in this video. Recently, I've been working on a project that makes it incredibly easy to control and interact with Arduino-based projects. It's called the Asynchronous Web Controller for ESP32. Here I have a PCB with 256 RGB LEDs arranged using the golden ratio. I've been able to create some awesome animations with it, but there isn't a simple way to control the animations. I could add some kind of button or other input that would allow me to cycle the animations or colors, but that wouldn't be very elegant. This is where the Async web controller comes in. Using the library I've built and my own custom ESP32 LED driver hardware, I've created an easy-to-use and powerful interaction system for this project. Here's how it works. The device creates its own Wi-Fi network, so let's go ahead and connect to it. You can see that a user interface immediately pops up, giving me full control over the LEDs. From here, I can toggle the power, adjust the brightness, select different animations, and adjust the color. It's super fast and works asynchronously while the animations are still playing. It even supports multiple clients connected at the same time. Other projects have achieved the same result, but where this project differs is in its ease of implementation. Let me show you a simple example of just how easy this is to use. Here I have a blank Arduino sketch in Platform.io. I'll start by including my Async web controller library, as well as the standard Wi-Fi library. Next, I'll need to create an Async web controller object. I'll call this web controller, and I'll pass in a parameter for the title of the web page. Next, I'll create a simple toggle control object. This will appear as a toggle switch on the UI and will allow us to set a variable as either on or off. I'll pass in a reference to a variable called power, and I'll give this control the title of power switch. In the setup function, I'll set the Wi-Fi mode to access point and enable Wi-Fi with an example SSID and password. Next, I'll add the toggle control object we created earlier to the Async web controller class and call the begin function of the controller. Finally, I'll set pin 13 as an output, which is connected to an onboard LED. In my loop function, I'll set pin 13's output state to the power variable from earlier, and I'll add a call to the web controller's loop function as well. And that's it. If we upload the code, we can see the network, and when we connect, we are immediately presented with a toggle control that toggles the LED. With just a few lines of code, I have a custom, easy-to-use user interface without having to worry about any HTML, CSS, or JavaScript. I hope you've enjoyed this quick look at my latest project. If you have, consider subscribing so you won't miss my future update videos on the Async web controller. If you have any questions, leave a comment below. Thanks for watching!